Many of the times we think of investing money and managing finance without taking into consideration the loopholes that we have. So here are five habits that I've learned over the time to help myself manage personal finance. If a ship has a hole, instead of fixing it, if we are trying something else, obviously the ship is going to sink. So in the same way, these are few habits that burn a hole in the pocket, and that should be avoided. And all this I've learned the hard way. It is easier said than done, but I think we should start somewhere. Hi, this is Atya here. Welcome to my channel, and we discuss PhD, mindset, motivation, finance. Unless the awareness is not there, how will it get change? Awareness fuels motivation. Expense tracking is a beautiful way of analyzing where our savings are going more. So this is I think one. There are several apps, there are several online trackers, or if you don't want to do anything else, there is spreadsheet, Microsoft Excel. So that works as well for this kind of subject. Forward budgeting. Expense tracking and budgeting goes hand in hand. Recently I'm trying a method called as You Need a Budget. It's an online platform. It's a paid feature, but for students they offer 1 year of trial. Okay, students get 1 year of trial. After that it is paid. I will insert the demo somewhere. It's a beautiful platform where you can budget as well as you can expense track at the same time, and I highly recommend it. The premise on which this app works is that you allocate budget to money which you actually have in your account. For example, if say suppose tomorrow you are going to get 2000 rupees, that will not be considered in the budget. What is there actually in your account, that will be considered and only that will be used. Another way I can explain the system is, say suppose you have 5 envelopes. You have 10,000 rupees, you put 2000 rupees in each envelope. So 5 envelopes, 2000 rupees in each envelope. And each envelope you allocate as, say suppose, rent, groceries, fruits, semester fees. Okay, so now in such cases, say suppose you, from rent you need more money, okay, for to pay. Obviously 2000 rupees is not enough, so you take money from other envelopes. Okay, now what happens here is, when you take money from other envelopes, the money from those areas becomes less. And when every day you do this kind of budgeting, you actually realize how much of money is getting spent on categories which are not required. This app is highly recommended. As I said earlier, we speak a lot about investments and different other features of personal finance, but what we are not taking into consideration is how much. Always try to overlook the loopholes. So in such cases, not automating savings. Automation of savings is one of the, I think, most fundamental habits for any kind of salary. In such cases, it is of paramount importance that we automate savings. And this I've suggested in my previous video also, the best way to automate savings is to open an RD account, recurring deposit. You can open it in any bank. It helps. The amount gets deducted on the day it is open, so you can adjust the date as per the date of salary that you receive. If you receive salary a little later, you can adjust the date around the same date, so that whenever your salary comes, your first installment goes towards savings rather than spending. I'm a huge proponent of living below your means, spending from your own income rather than relying on others. And I think these credit cards have messed up our personal finance management more than anything else. First of all, they will attract interest. Using a debit card instead of a credit card will show you exactly what your worth is and how you can utilize it. In such cases, I think using a debit card more than the credit card helps for personal finance management. Credit cards are unnecessary stress unless you use it in emergencies, but emergencies don't come every day. And if the use of credit card becomes a habit, then you feel like every day there is emergency. So I think we need to rethink the way we are using credit cards. The final and the most common hole of the ship, it is impulse buying. Impulse buying means whenever there is sale, you buy. Whenever there is any discount, we buy. However, we don't actually need these things. And these sales are very time sensitive. So there'll be offer on a particular day or a particular few days. Festivals are cashed in. So all this happens. So the basic premise behind this is they are building a scarcity mindset. That means the commercials make you feel inadequate without that particular thing. Okay, this is the basic mentality behind all these consumerism and behind sales, behind giving discounts. So many of the times we impulse buy things that we do not even need or which are already in stock. So this is the basic premise. So one thing to note over here is that sales happen throughout the year, and if you miss one sale, the next sale will be somewhere around the corner only, around the next festival. Keeping a gap of around 7 days between buying and between the thought of buying and actually buying, that helps in decision making, because over time necessities remain but luxuries fade away. Let me know in the comment section which money making habit you dislike. Thank you.